what we have here is another deposition of oil-coated sand grains with heavy minerals. And the more I see this, the more I have to assume that the oil-coated sand grains have a similar density to the heavy minerals. If not, they wouldn't be falling out of transport at exactly the same place. I'm sure that the relief of the surface of the sand has something to do with it, but it also has to be related to the density of the sand grain that has oil coating it and the density of the heavy mineral. They're too similar not to do this. This is just regular old quartz sand. So this is not anything that has anything to do with peat. Definitely not peat. But you can definitely see the orange fluorescence of the oil-coated grains of sand that are caught in the edges of the heavy mineral relief that's on the beach. And there is a crab hole, and he has excavated contaminated sand out of his hole, which means that the tar product that he threw out of his hole was obviously buried. So what we have here is a subterranean contamination. And there's oil-coated grains of sand being blown by the sand. They're being trapped in the relief that the heavy minerals have provided by their differential erosion rates. This is definitely aeolian transport, evidence of aeolian transport moving contaminated sand down the beach. There's no doubt about it. And under normal white light, you can see these are typical heavy mineral deposits that occur naturally on this beach. And now under UV light, you can definitely see the orange glow of the individual grains of sand on the beach.